welcome, welcome, and thanks for joining and tuning into KRACHOUSE Entertainment. And this podcast where I remember I posted a video the other day where I talked about how I asked us Nigerians in the diaspora how we can start to help the people back home. Waiting there, they be say, I will cut to the chase, just cut with all the fine tuning talk and all the fine talks and tuning and all the sweet talks and just get straight to the point. I'm Henry KRACHOUSE and I'm going to be hosting this podcast from now on. It's going to be live streamed every Saturday evening. This very episode is just a test episode to see how the whole thing is gonna come out at the end of recording and editing and all that. And I'll be hosting this show in Pidgin English so that everybody in Nigeria, so that people in Nigeria will not say, hey, I don't understand what he's saying. What is he saying? He's speaking through the nose. You know, we're living in the diaspora. Sometimes we always like to show off because we feel we've been brainwashed to think that the diaspora is better than our home. So whenever we are outside of our home country, we always try to emulate or imitate the people. You know, when I know what I want to talk. So I don't want to miss you. So waiting there, they'll be say, I'll be hosting this show in Pidgin English so that mama and papa, uncle and auntie, sister and brother, cousins and nephews, may gonna come on, come over, come listen to what I get to talk. It's about us and helping our brothers and sisters back home. Don't be social media showing off your rigs watches, your expenses, your expensive rigs watches, your expensive mobile phones, and your power vehicle, your houses and all that, and how much you've got, and be showing off your shoes and your clothing. See, my people, Niger had, I won't make we're there in the diaspora, we don't make small money. Make we begin to help the people where they're back home. Because now, since when we don't hand over Nigeria, give these people, I don't want to be insulting people. I don't want to be mentioning names. I don't want to be like, be calling our help. Because we voted these people into these positions of authorities. And we have to be responsible and be ready to deal with it. We'll be ready to deal with the outcome of our actions, because every time there is an election in our country, we always like to be tribalistic. We always like to not see ourselves as one, as like Peter Obi once said, the people in the northern part of Nigeria don't buy bread cheap. They don't buy bread cheaper than the people from the south. The people in the east don't buy anything cheaper than the people in the west. So, but every time there is an election, every time an election comes up in Nigeria, we always put on this tribalistic uniform and start talking about, hey, it's not our people. We have to vote for our person. He's not a Yoruba person. He's not an Igbo person. He's not Hausa. He's not Fulani. He's not Ibibio. He's not Efe. He's not Igala. He's not Tif. He's not, name it. We always forget that we are Nigerians and that we are all in the same boat. We always forget that we are all in the same ship, and this ship is sinking. Has been sinking, it's still sinking. It's sinking, is always, it's almost half, I don't know how to put it, but it's like the ship has been sinking for years now. It's almost about to be covered by the sea. We used to buy fuel 150 naira per liter. 2009, we've been there by for 150 naira per liter. If they mix this thing, Pidgin, and the throw-ins of English, then, you know, make you pardon me, say, because you know, say, I don't live outside of Nigeria day. So I they forget sometimes when I speak Pidgin, I could always want to put English in. But I will try to keep it, make it strictly Pidgin, because it is for Nigerians. Whether they talk to my people, Nigerians, where they are abroad, where they, there is no single Nigerian who doesn't understand and speak Pidgin English. Any Nigerian who tells you he or she can speak Pidgin English is straight up lying to your face. So within there, they say, this ship where we don't stay, this place where they call Nigeria, where all of us, we stay in this boat together. No matter where you're from, you're from the north, you're from the south, you're from the east, you're from the west, you're of northeast, not to hell with all that. We there for that place, that geographical part of Africa where they call Nigeria. And things don't they hard pass the way where ordinary Nigerians feed endure. We've been there by for 150 naira, like in 2009. Fast forward to now. Subsidy has been removed. Our Oga head of state saying could remove subsidy if we vote and put them for power. Like I talk, I no one insult our head of state because now we vote and put for that place. So making they do in own, but my thing be say, we where they are Wodo Ibo, where we they come on social, you know yourself, you know yourself. You where they come social media, they show your Gucci bags, they show your Rick's watches, they show your necklaces, they show your cars. Even if you be Yahoo boy, I don't want to know what you they do, they get money. But enough of all the bullshit, enough of coming to on social media to show off your wealth. Time don't reach where we begin think of waiting how we could take fix our home. And nobody say we could just they talk, say fixing, fixing, fixing. No, make we begin to put our money where our mouth be. What do I mean be say? You don't reach time where we make we begin give back. All the money where you they take go buy expensive clothing, expensive shoes. If you don't know how much that 50 euros, you don't know how much that $10, you don't know how much that 20 pounds, the change is where that 20 pounds, that $10, that 5 euros, you don't know what if it do for a person in Nigeria. So we don't reach time make we begin to give back. May we forget our sentiment and our tribalistic way of thinking. May we put them away. May we begin give back. Think of what we fit do to uplift the life of the less privileged way there for Niger, where we don't live for Niger. Because nobody say nobody say everybody go want Jaguar for Niger. Because if we begin jackpot for Niger, what thing could happen to our homeland? Nobody say we jackpot finish, foreigners could go our homeland, go they buy them up. If they buy them up, but by the time you come finish, won't go back, what thing you could won't go back to? So the people where they home, make them day there, but we wait on the outside, but we they think of waiting how we could fit, help them. As you say, I just created this little studio, make it be like, say, I just chill, I get pillows by my side and everything, so make me yarn. Don't be saying a fancy thing. I don't want any fancy stuff. The only fancy thing where there is to do now, this mic where you see so, and that 20 euros, that ain't cost. So no fancy things. Waiting my thing be say, now they talk, people they always talk, say, Nigeria hard, hey. We will change the bad politicians, they are corrupt. Before, as you talk, I'm so they look in the mirror. Ask yourself, say, these politicians, now who vote them put for that place? Now who votes them put for that place? They ask yourself that. Like, try hard things talk, politicians bad, they steal money, they do this. Now who vote them put there? Maybe you talk, say, now your person. You no one votes the right person because he know from your village. So my thing be say, waiting you fit do. By that I mean no more talking. No come here, no stop. dey show off your wealth, because people dey wey no dey see three food chop. People dey wey no dey see food chop. Make I repeat am. People dey wey no dey see food chop. Fuel price don increase now to 700 naira. As I see am so, I'm looking at it reaching like 1,500. Should we go to buy for 1,500? Una go to buy for 1,500 in Nigeria, because no be me. I no live in Nigeria. But because of the love we are get for Nigeria, because of the love we are get for the people where they home, we are get for my homeland, I make I want start this podcast. I make I want start this project. Let's start giving back. Let's start giving. You go come out, go shop. If you live in America, you live in Canada, live in the UK, you enter a supermarket, you enter a boutique, you spend €1,000. You spend £500, spend $1,000 on clothing and shirts and shoes, and to do your hair. Take $5, €5, £5 of that money and give to someone, donate to a charity organization in Nigeria. If charity organization no day where you feel trust, give to somebody. You know people where do they know, you know people where they inside situation. Take $5, take $10, take $20, any of pounds, euros, remove them, give to this to that family. Give to that family where you know say their situation no they tight. We were there on social media, we will be creators and they create shows, they collect money, they make money. Take some part of that money, donate it to some people where know they see food chop. You know them. It's not only about collecting. If you live for Nigeria, you they do skit. If you be a musician, you live in Nigeria. Roads no good in Nigeria. You don't get electricity. But you won't buy the most expensive vehicle where if you drive for Nigeria. You go commode a lot of millions of naira buy car where you won't drive them. You buy a car where you don't get road to drive ammo. So take small money out of that and help people. Go to the poor impoverished neighborhoods and donate. Buy food. Give. Just donate to people. Help people. Make we begin give back. So now waiting. Make I want to start this podcast with that. This first episode is sort of make it very simple, very short. Then the next episode I will go live. Go live, my PC, laptop could be here, so that make you know, tune in, make we talk. So that tune in, make we talk, make we just rub minds, waiting how we feed health. I'm not asking you guys to give me money, no. I'm asking you to give. You know people where no sit. You know people where their conditions no sit. You know them. Find a way and donate to those people. Nigeria hard, and it no be their fault, say the country hard. Now understand, nobody say that they are false. I know say, you know say, these politicians, they always weaponize this poverty thing. They use it against the people, and the people don't know. You don't know what thing person feed do for 50,000 naira. You don't know what thing person feed do in Nigeria for a bag of rice. So when time for election come reach, them go bring a person where don't loot money, go buy a bag of rice. Give some poor people 50,000, you know, and they go just blindly go out and vote that person back into that same position of authority. So the next episode will be next Saturday. I will go live. I will post the time where I will go live here, so that make one fit, but I could only go live. I've been talking saying the first episode I will give away 100,000 naira from my own pocket. But I will only do that when people don't watch. I want people just watch the show. You know, we get Instagram page where we new. So go there and subscribe. We get TikTok page that is also new. We don't get any subscribers, nothing. Our YouTube channel is still there. We get a little bit. One subscription, so that like, share this program. Let people know what thing we want to do, what thing KRACHOUSE don't start to do. And if you, so that make them con- just help people. Help people. Waiting you fit do be say share this show, like, and just subscribe. Go to Instagram and subscribe. Go to TikTok and follow, YouTube and follow and subscribe. In the next episode, I will be live. I will go live, but I will only go live when there is enough people that where we fit communicate and talk. So till then, I want you guys to stay healthy, stay blessed, and think about waiting. I just yarn so in this very video. I will see you guys next Saturday. Till then, I'm Hendrik KRACHOUSE. Peace and out.